The elder son of Indira Gandhi into the Indian political scenario. Rajiv Gandhi, who had initially entered politics just to support her mother, later became the most senior member of the cabinet in the executive branch of government, also known as the Prime Minister. Hostel 5, 8, 7 and Tanza presents Prime Minister! Congress lost the 1989 general elections, and after Rajiv Gandhi, BPC, who was the defense minister in Rajiv Gandhi's cabinet, took the office of Prime Minister. But his coalition government could not last for even a year, and it collapsed on 10th November 1990. This is a few months after the fall of BPC's government and the announcement of new general elections. 13th May 1991, Congress Party Headquarters, New Delhi.
So, if it wasn't for your brother's death, you would have never joined politics.
Wise people say, never say never. But I am not that wise. So yeah, never. I was happy being a pilot and leading a simple life. I mean, howsoever simple I could keep it, being the Prime Minister's son. But it was simple. Nice and simple.
So politics never fascinated you?
No.
Not even the power associated with it?
No. In fact, power used to scare me. Remember that famous line? With great powers come great responsibilities. And like most of the youngsters, I too was afraid of responsibilities.
Interesting. So what changed that? What made you take up the responsibility of becoming the Prime Minister of this country?
Situation. A man has to do what situation prompts him to. And situations prompt aloud when they are accidents. It was 3rd June, 1984.
Our history will never forget the day on which a historic decision was made by a Prime Minister who had run out of options. The day of Operation Blue Star. The Golden Temple with full force. Unexpectedly, they faced heavy resistance from inside.
पर खेद की बात यह है कि इस ऑपरेशन में बड़ी संख्या में मासूम भक्तों की जाने गए।
It was disastrous, a domestic military operation of unseen proportion, and that too on a religious place. The Sikhs were devastated. It had to have repercussions, and so it happened.
tensions among the Sikh population have finally reached the climax as the country witnessed today the killing of PM Indira Gandhi by one of her Sikh bodyguards. Political turmoil continues to escalate in all parts of the country as the country is already reeling under violent riots.
आज हम सबके लिए बहुत शोक का दिन हमारे देश की प्रधानमंत्री श्रीमती इंदिरा गांधी की उन्हीं के अंगरक्षकों द्वारा गोली मारकर हत्या कर दी गई। गौरतलब है I still remember the time when I received the news. It was unreal. I was shocked. My mind was not able to realize what has happened. As if it has lost the power to process any information. I couldn't believe it. But what happened next was even more unbelievable. Something which changed my life forever.
While we have received no official word from the Communist Party, sources suggest that Indira Gandhi's son, Rajiv Gandhi, is the front runner for being the PM.
सबकी निगाहें कांग्रेस हेडक्वार्टर्स पर हैं, जहां किसी भी वक्त ये अनाउंस किया जा सकता है कि क्या राजीव गांधी इस पद को स्वीकार करने के लिए तैयार है या नहीं। My mother expired and I was supposed to take up a job which I was neither ready nor fit for. But ultimately, it had to happen. It was presented to me as the most obvious thing to do. And eventually, I had to accept it.
After much of anticipation, it has finally been announced. Rajiv Gandhi will be the next Prime Minister of our country. He has asked the President to dissolve the current house and hold fresh elections. The elections will be held next month.
Yes, I did.
Sir, आप ready हैं?
नहीं, 5 minutes और.
Okay, sir. Sir,
5 minutes. बस हो गया.
सर 2 घंटे पहले भी आपने कहीं यही कहा था यू वर सपोज टू एड्रेस द नेशन 3 hours अगो
आई नो बस 5 मिनट आई एम ऑलमोस्ट डन
क्या मैं आपकी कुछ मदद कर सकता हूँ
ओह थैंक गॉड यू हियर विश्वनाथ जी आई एम नॉट श्योर अबाउट दिस
द स्पीच
यस देखिए ना द ओपनिंग इज वेरी
मैंने पढ़ी है इट्स फाइन
बट ये
बट यू आर नर्वस
नो आई एम नॉट Yes, I am.
There is nothing to be nervous about.
Of course there is. It's my first speech as the Prime Minister of this country.
Don't worry, sab sahi hoga. Just go and get it over with. The country is waiting to hear from their new Prime Minister.
Okay, just 5 more minutes.
So, let's go. We are getting late.
Just a second.
So, what are we waiting for?
Prabhu, hurry up.
Yes, sir. Here it is.
You are waiting for a pen?
It's my lucky pen.
Okay. Let's go.
नमस्कार ताजा जानकारी के अनुसार अब से बस कुछ ही देर में प्रधानमंत्री श्री राजीव गांधी देश के नाम एक संदेश देंगे। वो सुबह 9 बजे देश को संबोधित करने वाले थे लेकिन किन्हीं जरूरी संवैधानिक औपचारिकताओं में फंसे होने के कारण वो अब शाम 5 बजे आप सबसे मुखातिब होंगे। धन्यवाद। Welcome, sir. It's an honor to meet you. Shall we start?
No. I mean, yes. In 5 minutes. Can I have a glass of water?
Sure. Dada, pani laiye sir ke liye. Sir, bas ek minute.
Don't worry, sir. It will be all right.
No, it won't. And it's Rajiv. Call me Rajiv. Not sir. I am Rajiv Gandhi.
No, sir. You are the Prime Minister of India. Believe it or not?
देशवासियों आज मेरे लिए बहुत ही गर्व और शोक का दिन है। गर्व इसीलिए क्योंकि मैं आज भारत के छठे प्रधानमंत्री के रूप में कार्यभार संभाल।
I don't remember seeing that speech. How was it?
Bad. Probably the worst by any PM ever.
Seriously? That bad?
I'm telling you, you wouldn't be sitting here wanting to write my biography if you would have seen that speech.
So things were hard initially. Quite understandable. So tell me, how was your first day in office?
My first day? Again, bad. Very bad.
Sir, party meeting shaam 6 baje ki tay hui hai.
Theek hai, main yahi hoon.
सर अभी बहुत वक्त है, मेरे ख्याल से आपको घर जाकर कुछ देर रेस्ट करना चाहिए। इट्स गोइंग टू बी अ लॉन्ग डे सर।
नो आई एम फाइन
सर। यू कैन गो नाउ
सर। प्लीज आई एम फाइन।
सो व्हाट्स दिस मीटिंग अबाउट?
नथिंग इंपॉर्टेंट। देवावी
यो ये लुक वेरी टेंस। व्हाट इज इट अबाउट?
आई सेड नथिंग इंपॉर्टेंट। लेट्स मूव अहेड। वेयर वर वी?
तो योर फर्स्ट डे।
Welcome, sir.
Thank you. But why are you standing here? You're the defense minister, not my personal secretary.
आपका पहला दिन था तो मैंने सोचा।
Okay, thanks for that.
By the way, sir, you did well yesterday.
Are you kidding me?
No, sir. This way, sir.
But I think मेरा ऑफिस उस तरफ।
हाँ, sir. पर अभी कैबिनेट मीटिंग है।
Oh yes, I forgot. सब आ चुके हैं?
Yes, sir. सारे ministers आ चुके हैं। आपका इंतजार कर रहे हैं।
इंतजार कर रहे हैं? क्या मैं लेट आया हूँ?
नो सर।
आप मुझे बता सकते हैं अगर मैं लेट आया हूँ? मुझे ऑफिस टाइमिंग्स नहीं पता।
आई बेग योर पार्डन सर, बट डिड यू नॉट व्हाट टाइम योर मदर यूज्ड टू कम इन एंड गो बैक फ्रॉम ऑफिस?
यू नो व्हाट, आई कुड नेवर फिगर दैट आउट। शी वाज प्रैक्टिकली हियर ऑल द टाइम।
यस सर, एंड दैट्स योर आंसर।
व्हाट डू यू मीन? द ऑफिस वर्क्स
अराउंड द क्लॉक सर।
Because it does. It's the Prime Minister's office.
No, sir. वैसे तो defined as both.
I understand. Let's go inside.
Ask them to sit down. Ask them to sit down, sir.
Oh yes. Please sit down.
आदरणीय राजीव गांधी जी, इससे पहले आज की कार्यवाही शुरू करें, सभी मंत्रियों की तरफ से आपको भारत का प्रधानमंत्री बनने की बधाई और ढेरों शुभकामनाएं देना चाहूंगा।
धन्यवाद
सर। जैसा कि आपको पहले ही पता होगा, ये आज की मीटिंग का एजेंडा है, तो अब आपके आज्ञा से हम मीटिंग शुरू करें।
हाँ जरूर।
But actually, you are supposed to tell them which issue you want to discuss first.
Oh yeah, yeah. Of course, मैं उसी बारे में सोच रहा था. So how about we start the discussion with this one, the deduction of food prices in government canteen.
Thank you, sir. I think it is a very major issue and we should discuss about it seriously. So sir, the issue is that the price of samosa in the government canteen has increased from 10 paise to 25 paise.
One minute, please. Sir, are you sure you want to discuss this first? I mean, there are several other issues which are more important.
You only asked me to choose.
Yes, sir, and I'm asking you again. Shall we continue this issue or...
I don't know. If you feel like...
It's okay, sir. You can continue.
Okay. So sir, as I was saying, the price of samosa in the government canteen has increased from 10 paise to 25 paise. It is not fair, sir. Samosa is the lifeline of government officials, sir. I think we should think of reducing the prices of samosas and chais in the government canteen.
क्या भैया, कहाँ हैं तुम्हारे प्रधानमंत्री? 10 बजे की प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस थी, 11 बज रही है।
अरे यार समझा करो, पहला दिन है, पहली कैबिनेट मीटिंग।
भैया पहली स्पीच देने में तो कल लंगोट टाइट हो गई थी इनकी, आज प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में कहीं टाइपर की जरूरत ना पड़े।
भैया नहीं, तुम बकवास मत करो, वो प्रधानमंत्री है और वो भी ऐसे जैसे कभी नहीं हुए। पता है ना 534 में से पूरी 441 सीट जीते हैं वो लोकसभा में।
देख भैया, अपनी माँ की चिता पर बैठ कर इलेक्शन जीतना बहुत आसान काम है, असली अगली परीक्षा तो अब शुरू हुई है। देखते हैं क्या करते हैं तुम्हारे साहब। अबे ये है कहाँ साला, 11 बज गया बे।
ओके वन मिनट प्लीज बैठ जाइए। देखिए मुझे लगता है हमें प्रधानमंत्री जी को कुछ और समय देना चाहिए ताकि वो अपने सलाहकारों से मशवरा लेकर किसी नतीजे पे पहुंच सके। क्यों सर?
जी जैसा आप कहें, मेरा मतलब है, हाँ सही कह रहे हैं आप।
ओके सो आई थिंक हमें ये मीटिंग यहीं खत्म करनी होगी, प्रेस सर का इंतजार कर रही है, सो वी कंटिन्यू दिस टुमारो। चलिए सर।
थैंक्स, प्रेस का बहाना बनाकर बचा लिया आपने। आई वॉज गेटिंग विप्ड।
यू आर वेलकम सर, बट मैंने आपको बचाया नहीं है। यू एक्चुअली हैव अ प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस नाउ।
व्हाट, अ प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस? नहीं, अभी उस कैबिनेट मीटिंग से कहां उबर पाया हूं मैं, अभी प्रेस के सामने नहीं जा सकता।
सर यू हैव टू। एंड हु आर यू?
सर आई एम ब्रिजभूषण शर्मा, पर्सनल एडवाइजर टू द पीए, दैट इज यू।
ओह थैंक्स फॉर टेलिंग मी दैट, बट मैं अभी कोई प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस अटेंड नहीं कर रहा।
ओह सो इट वाज ट्रू?
व्हाट वाज ट्रू?
दैट यू आर अफ्रेड ऑफ द मीडिया?
नो आई एम नॉट।
एंड वेयर डिड यू हियर दैट? जस्ट हियर एंड देयर, बट इट्स ट्रू।
नो इट्स नॉट। एंड माइंड योर लैंग्वेज, आई एम योर बॉस।
Yes, you are my boss and also media for me.
That's not even a word.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. Vishnu ji, aap please is badtameez insaan ko bataiye ki media phobic is not a word and drag him out of my office.
Well, I'm not sure whether that's a word or not, but you are a little media phobic.
What? How can I be something which is not even a word? Okay, so you do think that I'm afraid of missing media?
Yeah.
Okay. मैं अभी प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में जाऊंगा एंड आई विल प्रूव दैट आई एम नॉट मीडिया फोबिक।
यस सर।
ओके आई विल गो।
आफ्टर यू सर।
ओके डू आई रियली हैव टू?
यस सर।
ओह माय गॉड, आपको इतना डर लगता था मीडिया से, बट यू फाइनली डिड गो फॉर दैट प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस, डिडंट यू?
वेल आई हैड नो चॉइस।
सो योर फर्स्ट स्पीच वाज बैड, योर फर्स्ट कैबिनेट मीटिंग वाज बैड। How was your first press conference? Was it bad too?
No, it was not bad. It was the worst. I was about to learn a very important lesson.
And what would that be?
That I was not Indira Gandhi's son anymore. I was India's prime minister.
Sir, excuse me.
Sir, how was your first cabinet meeting?
Well, it was good. You can say that.
Can you give us a few details?
I would like to. It's just that I don't know much. Anyways, you'll be briefed about the meeting by the press secretary.
Sir, Indira ji ke nidhan ke baad se jo desh ke anek hisson mein dange phailay hue hain, unhe rokne ke liye aapki sarkar kya kadam uthayegi?
वो भी जरूरी होगा। सरकार अपनी पूरी ताकत लगा देगी इन दंगों को खत्म करने के लिए।
सर, ऐसा देखा गया है कि आपकी पार्टी के कुछ कार्यकर्ता दंगे भड़काने का काम कर रहे हैं, इस बारे में आप क्या कहना चाहेंगे?
I am not aware of any such thing, but the government criticizes such action and our party estranges such political activists.
Sir, do you mean to say that riots happened without instigation from your party? We have proof that Congress workers are involved in them.
There is no instigation whatsoever from the party. India has lost a great leader and the riots are just a reaction to it. देखिए, एक बड़ा पेड़ गिरता है तो उसके नीचे की धरती हिलती ही है।
ये क्या कह रहे हैं
सर? Do you mean to trivialize the killing of thousands of Sikhs as bharti ka
nahi? Aap logo ko justify to nahi kar rahe?
Ye masoomon ki maut ka zimmedar kaun hai?
Okay, jaan bataiye. That's all for today. The PM will leave now. All your questions will be answered by the press secretary. Thanks for coming.
Oh, तो यहाँ पे आपने वो फेमस बड़ा पेड़ वाला स्टेटमेंट दिया था।
उस वक्त मुझे पता नहीं था कि वो स्टेटमेंट कितना बड़ा है और वो पेड़ एक्चुअली मेरे ही सिर पर गिरा है।
So, here are the minutes of yesterday's cabinet meeting.
Oh yes, the damn meeting.
तो चिंता मत करिए, you will get hold of things. शुरू-शुरू में होता है. Even your mother was like this in the beginning.
तुम उन्हें जानते थे?
हाँ सर, I told you ना, I've been here for the past 20 years.
इसीलिए इतने बदतमीज हूँ.
Sorry sir.
By the way, was she really like me in the beginning?
Sir, to be frank, no. She was not like you.
I thought so.
No. What I meant was, she was even worse. एक बार किसी गांव के दौरे में किसी ने उनसे कहा कि इस गांव के लोगों के पास खाने को रोटी तक नहीं। तो पता है वो क्या बोली? बोलती है, तो ब्रेड क्यों नहीं खा लेते? सोचिए सर, रोटी नहीं तो ब्रेड। Sorry sir, I was just joking. आपको कॉन्फिडेंस दिलाने के लिए।
You were trying to boost my confidence by telling me that I am the son of a stupid mother.
No sir, that was not what I meant.
I know what you meant. ये बहुत famous joke था उनके बारे में। ये बताने के लिए कि वो विदेश में पली बड़ी हैं और इस देश के बारे में कुछ नहीं जानती।
और देखिए लोग अब क्या कहते हैं उनके बारे में। जब उन्होंने एक विदेशी की इमेज से यहाँ तक का सफर तय कर लिया तो फिर आपके लिए तो ये रास्ता बहुत ही आसान है।
आइए विश्वनाथ जी, tell me, what's the latest update on the riots?
They are under control. I think एक दो दिन में सब नॉर्मल हो जाएगा। No need to worry about it now.
That's a good news. आपको क्या हुआ?
कुछ नहीं।
Tell me, what is it? आप खुश नहीं दिख रहे।
नहीं, ऐसी बात नहीं। मैं खुश हूँ।
Oh come on, what is it?
It's yesterday's press conference.
Press conference? What did I do wrong now?
You said एक बड़ा पेड़ गिरता
है। Oh please, not that statement.
Yes.
Are you telling me that stupid statement has created some sort of trouble for me?
Yes, it has.
God damn it. It was just something that came to my mind. For God's sake, it was just a statement.
It was not just a statement. It was the statement of the Prime Minister of India.
So were the other things
yes.
I said. But nobody seems to pay attention to them.
I know.
So what am I supposed to do now? Go and apologize to them?
No, but a clarification will be good.
Clarification? Clarification of what?
That you think mean what they think you meant and tell them what you actually meant.
I can't believe this. It's like whatever I say is blown out of proportion and then I am supposed to clarify everything. Boy, I am not the one who created this frenzy at the first place. And what's the guarantee that they will not make out something else this time?
Rajiv, don't behave like a child. It's a simple thing. You said something people misunderstood. So you need to clarify. That's it. And you know why people don't pay attention to the other things you said? Because those things don't make the headlines. These things do and you need to understand these things. So don't behave like a child and act like a PM should do. Take your ass up to that podium and clarify. It's as simple as that.
That day, when I asked you to call me Rajiv, you said I'm the PM.
Yes, sir. You are the PM.
But you just called me Rajiv.
Yes, I did. And I'm sorry for that.
You also scolded me like a schoolboy.
And I'm sorry for that too. Won't happen again. Shall we go now?
It's just that. I want it to happen again. I mean, whenever I need it. Please.
With pleasure, sir.
I was very dependent on Vishwanath ji in my initial days. Har kadam kadam par unhone mujhe mentor kiya hai. But then slowly, I gained confidence by making tough and important decisions.
So, which were these decisions?
Yes, Prabhu. Tell me. What is it?
Sir, these are some notes I prepared. I think they'll be helpful in today's meeting.
That was not required. You're worrying too much. It'll be fine.
I hope so, sir.
You worry too much, Prabhu. You worry too much.
Sir, can I know what is it that he's so worried about?
It's nothing.
It's got to be something. ऐसा क्या डिस्कस होने वाला है आज की पार्टी मीटिंग में?
You will know when you need to know. Right now, let's continue.
Prabhu, you can leave.
So, where were we?
You were telling me about your important and tough decisions.
I was the Prime Minister. All my decisions were important and almost all of them were tough too.
Yeah, but which was your first one?
The first one?
Yes, the first one. Tell me about it.
11.2%?
Yes, sir.
So you mean to say that by the time I finish my tenure, there'll be around what, 10 crore more people in my country?
Yes, sir.
That's humongous. Do you know that countries like Switzerland don't even have a total population of 10 crores? It's like we're producing new countries each year.
And they called my brother a dictator. Compared him to Hitler when he tried to implement the family planning scheme.
His methods were...
I know what his methods were. And I don't agree with them either. But we will have to do something to stop this. We can't afford to produce new countries each year. We are having tough times supporting the one we have. Aiyah Vishwanathji, did you know that by the time I complete my tenure, there'll be 10 crore more people in our country?
No, sir.
Don't you think that's humongous?
Yes, it is, sir. Sir, but...
So don't you think we should do something about it?
Yes, maybe, sir, but...
But what?
Sir, but the reason I came here is something else. Something important has come up.
More important than this?
At this moment, yes.
Okay, just give me 1 minute.
Sir, it's urgent. We have to do it right now.
We should have this discussion later. We can leave.
So we should talk about this on our way to the office.
So tell me, what is it?
Sir, please. Sir, a situation has come up on the Indo-Pak border in Rajasthan. About an hour ago, 5 Indian civilians have accidentally crossed the border and entered the Pakistani territory.
What do you mean, accidentally crossed the border? There is a fence, right?
In the desert? Not everywhere, sir.
So, why can't they come back?
The Pakistani army have taken them into custody.
So, shall I talk to the Pakistani PM and ask him to release them?
It's not that simple, sir.
And why would that be?
Because the Pakistani army is claiming that they are not civilians, but Indian spies.
What?
And there is more to it, sir. They have demanded the release of 3 of their ISI spies, whom we captured last month, in return of these 2 people.
They have demanded this, as in a ransom?
You can call it that.
So when you said that they have taken them into custody, what you actually meant was, they have held them hostage?
Yes, sir.
I can't believe this. They are civilians for God's sake. And all of this happened in last 1 hour. All of this.
Yes, sir.
So what now? What shall we do?
Sir, the military chief is waiting for us in the situation room. He will let us know about the available options.
Okay. Let's go.
The situation room.
Yeah, the place in Prime Minister's office from where they monitor and tackle situations like these.
Sir,
tell me, what can be done?
Sir, we have located the army base where they have been kept hostage. It's around 50 kilometers from the border. It's not a very tightly secured area.
What's the strength?
Sir, around 25 to 30 armed men. By land to a precise, no tanks or anything. It's a small base.
Then why have they kept them there?
Because it's near to the border. And they're hoping for a quick response from us. They will be shifting them to a more secured location in an hour or so. If they don't hear from us.
Okay, so... We only have a few hours if you want to carry any command operation.
Wait a second. When did that come into picture?
Sir, that is something we are considering.
A command operation? On a military base?
Yes, sir.
Isn't it dangerous?
All command operations are, sir.
But here, 5 civilians are involved.
Sir, but we need to...
Why aren't you considering to agree to the demand?
I wouldn't suggest that, sir. That will only motivate them
to... I know that. But a command operation on a military base sounds too dangerous.
Sir, they are trained for such situations.
Don't we have any other option?
I don't think so, sir.
what if we don't respond to them at all?
It's not like they're going to kill them, are they?
After all, they also know that they are civilians, not spies.
It doesn't matter, sir.
What do you mean it does not matter? Of course it matters.
No, sir. Not to them. They will kill them.
They will?
Yes, sir. For sure.
I need some time to think. How much do I have?
Sir, our teams are already in position. They will come in as soon as you order.
10 minutes. Can I have 10 minutes?
Yes, sir.
More secured location otherwise. So sir, please, if you could...
They said I have 10 minutes.
Yes, sir.
I was just thinking, when? When did I become so powerful?
I don't
understand, sir. 5 people's knowledge will depend on my decision. And not to talk about the commandos who will be risking their lives as well. When did I become so powerful?
The day you became the PM, sir.
The day I was made the PM. I didn't sign up for this voluntarily.
It doesn't matter, sir. You are the PM now.
Yes, I am. You know, kuch saal pehle tak, dopahar 11 baje, mere dimag mein sabse important sawal ye hota tha, ki what would I have for lunch today? I wonder, when will I get that life back?
Never, sir. You will never get that life back. You know why? Because that's too ordinary. And you are too special to have a life like that. You are not here because of some accident. You are here because you are destined to and you deserve it. I know you don't realize it yet, but the sooner you do, the better it will be for you and for the whole country. So, if you really care that much about your lunch, then don't reach that. Go inside and do what you're supposed to. So, it's the army chief. They are waiting.
Okay, let's do it.
Yes, sir. You have the PM's order. Go ahead.
Yes, sir.
We have the PM's. Go ahead. Commence the operation from that.
Yes, sir. Boys, commence operation.
What's the distance to target?
Sir, 200 meters and closing in.
Bring up the video feed on the main monitor.
Sir, we are waiting on it.
Do we have a visual on the target?
No, not yet, sir.
Okay.
So, what's the progress?
Sir, division is building. That's their base. And these white dots coming in, they are our commandos.
These dots? But they are so close.
Yes, sir. They were already there.
What? What the hell do you mean by asking for my permission then? What if I would not have ordered this operation?
The boys would have come back, sir. But we are faith in you. You made the correct decision, sir.
Unit, me and Singh will enter from back. Rest of you, attack from front. Sir, we are inside the guard house.
Okay, any casualties?
No, sir.
Back out, you are close. Move in cover, move stealthy.
Thank you.
announce that the government is founding the company Mahanagar Telephone Nigam Limited, MTNL. Aaj telephone status ki baat hai. Aam janta ki bahut se dur hai. But now, every home and every office will have a telephone. Controlled by the state and licenses are given to a select few. I want the corruptions of this license raj to go. There will no longer be private monopolies created by issuing of government licenses. There will be equal opportunities for all companies. I am young and I too have a dream. I dream of an India, strong, independent and self-reliant, and on the front ranks of the nations of the world, in the service of mankind.
And so began the tenure, which still many call the most glorious years of Indian history post-independence.
Thanks for saying that.
Sir, they are here. It's time. Sir?
Yeah. अच्छा, तुम पूछ रहे थे ना कि आज की ये मीटिंग किस बारे में है? हम इस मीटिंग में ये तय करने वाले हैं कि आने वाले लोकसभा चुनावों में हमारी पार्टी की तरफ से पीएम पोस्ट का कैंडिडेट कौन होगा।
इसमें तय करने वाली क्या बात है? जाहिर है पीएम पोस्ट के कैंडिडेट तो आप ही होंगे।
नहीं, इट्स नॉट गोना बी मी। And that's why we need televisions in cities, in towns, in villages, everywhere. Because information is the next big thing. Do one thing, send all the papers I need to sign to my office. And that's all for today. Thank you. Vishwanath ji, aap ek minute rukiye.
So, how's your visit to Russia?
Good. It went good.
And any new agreement concerning the defense ministry?
No. Nothing as such.
Then why am I here?
Do you know what was the biggest challenge that the Indian Army faced in the 1962 war against China?
The cold weather of the Himalayas?
No, I mean yes. But that was not the biggest challenge. The weather was cold for the Chinese too. Their biggest challenge was to fight against a well-equipped Chinese army sitting at an altitude, using guns and tanks which had a range so less that even a shot put through can easily beat them.
Yeah, and that's why we are purchasing newer ones. As you know, the bids are already in.
Yeah, about that. Have you heard of 155mm howitzer?
Sir, I am the defense minister. Of course I have heard of them. They have a very good firing rate with an effective range of 21 kilometers. The 155mm howitzers, developed and manufactured by Bofors, are the best in the business.
So are we getting them?
That I don't know.
Come on, you're the defense minister.
Yeah, but it depends.
On what?
Their quotes, of course.
And they're not the lowest.
How do you know that?
A friend of mine told me. But that's not important. Are we getting them or not?
If their quotes are not the lowest, then no, we are not. But who told you what their quote is?
I just said, my friend.
Be specific.
How does it matter? You don't even know him.
I might know him. If his name is Ottavio Quattrochi. So, it is Quattrochi.
How do you know him?
He is an Italian middleman. And while his nearness to your family might be a secret to the rest of the world, but it is certainly not to me. I am no one to tell you whom you should be friends with or what you should or should not talk to your friends about. But as the defense minister of this country, it's my duty to tell you that involving a middleman in a deal concerning national security is a crime.
Yes, I know that.
And I hope so.
Vishwanath ji, it's just that those howitzers are really good. The Indian army must have them.
I know, but that's not possible unless Bofors magically lowers their quota, which I don't see happening.
Yeah, the quotes. You know, संगे मरमर का ताज महल भी कभी नहीं बन पाता अगर शाहजहां ने भी कोर्ट्स मंगवाए होते और उसमें से भी लोएस्ट कोर्ट को चूज किया होता
सर पर हम शाहजहां नहीं हैं इसलिए द इंडियन आर्मी विल हैव टू वेट फॉर दिस ऑफिसर्स अनलेस दे गेट द रिसोर्सेज टू परचेस देम एंड राइट नाउ देयर कोर्ट इज अ लिटिल आउट ऑफ आवर बजट
राइट आई अंडरस्टैंड लेट्स कॉल इट अ डे
थैंक यू सर आई टेक योर
शांत हो जाइए शांत हो जाइए देखिए जाधव जी उस सीट से आपके भतीजे को टिकट नहीं दी जा सकती उस रोड कंस्ट्रक्शन वाले मामले में अभी अभी उसका नाम उछला है केस भी चल रहा है उस पर सुनिए देखिए बीपी सिंह की सरकार के अचानक गिर जाने से देश भर में जो राजनीतिक अस्थिरता आई है उसका पूरा फायदा कांग्रेस को मिल रहा है एक स्थिर सरकार के लिए लोग कांग्रेस की तरफ देख रहे हैं हमारी स्थिति बहुत मजबूत है और हमें इसका पूरा फायदा उठाना चाहिए ये निजी संबंधों को देख के हमें किसी भी सीट से ऐसा कोई उम्मीदवार खड़ा नहीं करना चाहिए जिसके जीतने की संभावना थोड़ी भी कम हो लोगों को कांग्रेस के अलावा कोई विकल्प नजर नहीं आना चाहिए यादव जी हम इस बारे में बाद में बात करेंगे नरसिंह राव जी आप बोलिए आप दक्षिण के बारे में कुछ कह रहे थे
जी मैं पार्टी का ध्यान दक्षिण भारत की ओर ले जाना चाहूंगा इस बात में कोई शक नहीं कि उत्तर भारत में कांग्रेस को जीतने से कोई नहीं रोक सकता लेकिन दक्षिण में कुछ परेशानी हो सकती है केरला और आंध्र तो फिर भी ठीक है पर कर्नाटका और खासकर तमिलनाडु में तो मुझे कांग्रेस का खाता भी खुलता नजर नहीं आ रहा क्यों राजीव जी क्या कहना है आपका इस बारे में राजीव जी तमिलनाडु के बारे में आपका क्या कहना है कोई रणनीति सोची है आपने वहां के बारे में क्या हुआ बोलिए
तमिलनाडु में भी हमारी रणनीति वही होगी जो बाकी पूरे देश में है रैलीज कैंपेन्स और अगर हमारी स्थिति वहां पे कमजोर है तो हम वहां ज्यादा ध्यान देंगे मैं खुद अपना कैंपेन वहीं से शुरू करूंगा
अरे ये क्या बोल रहे हैं आप तमिलनाडु जाएंगे
क्यों आपको कोई परेशानी है
राजीव जी वहां की जान को खतरा है एलटीटीई से कितने ही डेथ रेस आ चुके हैं आपको
हाँ ये बात तो सही है वहां जाना आपके लिए खुद मौत को ललकारने जैसा है
हाँ बिल्कुल बिल्कुल हमारे पास और भी नेता हैं जो साउथ में कंपेनिंग कर सकते हैं आप नॉर्थ पे कंसंट्रेट कीजिए
जी मेरा भी यही मानना है आपको साउथ और खासकर तमिलनाडु तो नहीं जाना चाहिए
प्लीज स्टॉप दिस नॉनसेंस एंड से व्हाट यू रियली वांट टू से मेरी जान के लिए झूठी चिंता दिखाना बंद करिए डेथ थ्रेट्स आई गेट 10 ऑफ देम डेली वी ऑल नो व्हाट दिस मीटिंग इज अबाउट सो लेट्स कट द क्रैप एंड गेट स्ट्रेट टू द पॉइंट
जी आप बात को गलत मोड़ दे रहे हैं
ओह रियली यादव जी के भतीजे को इलेक्शन टिकट नहीं देनी चाहिए क्योंकि उस पर केस चल रहा है गेस व्हाट आप सब पर भी केस चल रहा है एंड गेस व्हाट उनका भतीजा तो अभी सिर्फ 4 साल का है तो ये मनगढ़ंत कहानियां बनाना बंद कीजिए और नरसिम्हा जी आप कह रहे थे कि दक्षिण में हमारी हालत कमजोर है वेल आई हैव दीस नंबर्स फॉर यू पिछले इलेक्शन में हमें जो 197 सीट्स मिली थी ना उनमें से 40% सीट्स साउथ यानी दक्षिण की थी सो डोंट टेल मी कि मैं बात को गलत मोड़ दे रहा हूं मैं बात को उस ओर ले जा रहा हूं जहां आप सब ले जाना तो चाहते हैं पर हिम्मत नहीं है अगर किसी आदमी को आप मारना चाहते हैं ना तो कम से कम सामने आने की हिम्मत तो रखिए क्यों कायरों की तरह किसी के पीछे से बात क्यों कर रहे हैं
आप कायर किसे बोल रहे हैं लीजिए सीधे सीधे बोलते हैं पूरी पार्टी को लगता है कि आपने जो श्रीलंका में किया था उसके कारण तमिलियंस आपसे चिढ़े हुए हैं और बोफोर्स स्कैंडल के कारण आपकी क्लीन इमेज भी डॉक्टर हो गई है
बोफोर्स का मामला कोर्ट में है और अभी कुछ साबित नहीं हुआ है और श्रीलंका में जो मैंने किया वो एकदम सही था एंड आई स्टिल स्टैंड बाय माय डिसीजन
बट वी डोंट स्टैंड बाय एनी प्रोटेस्टेंस एंड वी डोंट वांट टू फेस द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ द लीडर
देखिए आप लोग शांत हो जाइए इस तरह लड़ने से कोई हल नहीं निकलेगा हम एक काम करते हैं एक ब्रेक लेते हैं आधे घंटे बाद मीटिंग फिर से शुरू करेंगे ठीक है चलिए चलिए
सर मेरे हिसाब से तो आदमी को दूसरों के झमेलों से दूर ही रहना चाहिए।
बिल्कुल सही बात है सर, इतिहास गवाह है जो दूसरों के झगड़ों में बीच बचाव करने जाता है अंत में वही दोनों तरफ से मार खाता है।
आरिफ जी, सर आई अग्री, इंटरवीनिंग इन श्रीलंका इंटरनल मैटर इज नॉट समथिंग आई विल सजेस्ट। और मुखर्जी दा आप? सर आई टोटली अग्री विद अदर्स। ओके, दैट्स प्रीटी मच इट, थैंक्स फॉर कमिंग।
You have already decided of intervening in Sri Lanka, haven't you? Sir, it's a bad idea. I will strongly suggest against it.
700 people have been killed so far in this movement. You know that?
Yes, sir. I do.
और फिर भी आप suggest कर रहे हैं?
Yes, sir. क्योंकि जो लोग मरे हैं वो श्रीलंकन्स हैं और ये उनके सरकार की जिम्मेदारी है कि उनकी रक्षा करे, हमारी नहीं।
पर उनकी सरकार इस काम को करने में सक्षम नहीं है। And that's why they have asked for our help.
सर कहते हैं कि सर्दी के मौसम में अपनी कमीज उतार के भिखारी को देने वाला दानवीर नहीं मूर्ख होता है। सर अगर आप श्रीलंकन गवर्नमेंट के सपोर्ट में एलटीटी के खिलाफ फौज भेजेंगे तो हमारे पूरे देश के तमिलियंस आपके खिलाफ हो जाएंगे, जाति की इमेज को भी इससे नुकसान होगा। आप जानते हैं तमिलियंस के खिलाफ कितने अत्याचार हुए श्रीलंका में, इसीलिए सारे तमिलियंस एलटीटी को सपोर्ट करते हैं। सर मैं फिर से बोलूंगा, दिस इज अ बैड आइडिया एंड यू शुड ड्रॉप इट इमीडिएटली।
जी मैं आपकी बात पर गौर करूंगा।
सर मेरी बात समझ,
मैंने कहा ना मैं आपकी बात पर गौर करूंगा। Anything else?
Yes, sir. एक और बात करनी थी आपसे।
बोलिए।
आज सुबह बोफोर्स के चीफ एग्जीक्यूटिव का कॉल आया था। आप जानते हैं उसने क्या कहा? वो लोग अपना कोट बदलना चाहते हैं।
Oh, really?
Yes. Isn't that a great coincidence that they've decided to change their coat just 2 days after you thought of giving them a chance to do so?
Yes, that's a coincidence.
A very big one.
You might say so.
I hope so, sir. I really hope so. Because if it's not, then I don't know.
Was it?
Huh?
Was it a coincidence?
I'm sorry. The case is in court and I'm not allowed to talk about it.
But VP Singh certainly believed it wasn't a coincidence.
Everyone is free to believe what they want to be.
So, yahin se aap dono ke beech darar aane lagi.
Haan, keh sakte hain. This is the point from where we started to have ideological differences. And what I did next pushed it to a point from where it was not possible for us to work together.
सर मेरे इतने समझाने के बावजूद भी आपने श्रीलंका में आर्मी भेज दी।
मैंने वही किया जो मुझे सही लगा।
You are not a dictator who can do whatever he wants to. You are the prime minister of a democratic country and you should not forget that.
And neither should you.
I'm sorry for the way that I talked, but I think you made a big mistake.
Mistake? You call saving people's lives a mistake? Helping a weak neighbor a mistake? Trying to uphold democracy a mistake? If these things are mistakes, then yes, I have committed not one but many mistakes. But guess what? I don't regret any of it.
But I do. I do regret that I saw a great leader in you, a visionary in you. I regret that I thought you could fill in the shoes of your mother.
Vishwanathji, don't call the
leader. You know, I ignored what you did in Bofors, thinking at least your intention was right. But you know what? Now I think that you took it as a license to do whatever you want.
Don't talk about things you know nothing about.
I think I know enough. I know enough for you to worry about me.
What do you mean?
पिछले हफ्ते देश का राजनीतिक माहौल उस समय गर्मा गया जब प्रधानमंत्री राजीव गांधी के करीबी माने जाने वाले वीपी सिंह को कैबिनेट से निकालते हुए
He soon left the party and made a new one named John Morcha.
It is believed that the reason of the rift between him and the Prime Minister is the PM's decision of sending the IPKF or the Indian Peacekeeping Force to Sri Lanka.
आज सुबह सुबह वीपी सिंह ने प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में ऐसा खुलासा किया है जिसने पूरे देश में हलचल मचा दी है। तो आइए आपको दिखा दें कि आखिर क्या हुआ उस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस में।
बता सकते हैं कि आपको कैबिनेट से इस तरह क्यों निकाला गया?
मैं पहले आपके सवाल को सुधारना चाहूंगा। मुझे कैबिनेट से निकाला नहीं गया, मैं खुद निकल गया हूं। और इसका कारण है इस प्रशासन में व्याप्त भ्रष्टाचार।
सर आर यू ट्राइंग टू पॉइंट टुवर्ड्स अ स्पेसिफिक केस?
यस आई एम।
मैं इस प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस के माध्यम से इस पूरे देश को रक्षा सौदे में हुए एक बहुत बड़ी धांधली के बारे में बताना चाहता हूँ। एक मिनट मुझे बोलने दीजिए। देखिए 155 होवित्ज़र्स की खरीदी में इंटरनेशनल मिडलमैन जिन्हें हम दलाल कहते हैं उनका इन्वॉल्वमेंट था और उन्हीं के कहने पे ये टेंडर गलत कंपनी को दिया गया।
कौन दलाल सर? कौन मिडलमैन?
We have come to know from Mr. VP Singh that in the Bobo scheme, the country has lost at least 65 crores. He has also hinted that your government received kickbacks from the company.
These are all false allegations. I can assure you that neither me nor any of the ministers from my cabinet has received any bribe.
Neither
Quadrochi nor any other middleman was involved in this deal, and the government has directly dealt with Bofors.
सर चुनाव के कुछ दिनों पहले आपने इतना बड़ा खुलासा किया है, जाहिर है इस चुनाव में भ्रष्टाचार ही आपका मुख्य मुद्दा होगा।
देखिए ये खुलासा मैंने चुनाव को मद्देनजर रखते हुए नहीं किया। देश की जनता को पता होना चाहिए कि उनके खून पसीने की कमाई किसके जेब में जा रही है और उसका कैसे इस्तेमाल हो रहा है। हमें बस ये लगता है कि भ्रष्टाचार करने वालों को उनके लिए भी सजा देश की जनता से बेहतर कोई नहीं दे सकता। धन्यवाद।
I don't think this will have any effect on the upcoming elections. These are baseless allegations and I have full faith on the people of our country to understand that.
Sir, but you cannot deny that your clean image has been dented by this allegation, baseless or not.
Images are not dented that easily, nor are they made that easily. I have worked hard and my work speaks for me. And when the people will weigh the things I have done for them against these false allegations, I am sure that the former will win. Thank you. कहते हैं बुरे वक्त पे साया भी साथ छोड़ देता है। आज मतलब समझ में आया। यही लोग जो अभी बाहर बैठे ये सोच रहे हैं कि मेरी जगह किसे पीएम का कैंडिडेट बनाया जाए, एक समय पे मुझे जबरदस्ती पीएम बनाने पे तुले हुए थे। जाहिर है उस वक्त उन्हें मेरी मां की मौत का फायदा उठाना था, और अब जबकि मुझ पर ये एलिगेशंस लगे हैं, सो दे वांट अ न्यू फेस नाउ सर। सो हु इज इट गोना बी?
Sir, there is one more thing. They want you to announce his name so that the media can...
Yeah, I know the math. Okay. Tell them that I will do that in tomorrow morning's press conference.
Yes, sir.
Anything else?
No, sir.
Then we will call it a day.
Okay, sir.
I said we will call it a day, which is a polite way of saying, get the hell out of here.
Sir, are you fine?
I'll be back. Now go.
Okay.
I think you should leave as well. We will continue tomorrow. I just got a lot of free time.
Okay, sir. I understand.
Good night. Good
आदमी कितना भी बड़ा क्यों ना हो जाए, बुरा सपना देखकर डर ही जाता है।
कौन है?
हम जब छोटे होते हैं तो अंधेरे से डरते हैं, भूत से डरते हैं।
आप
बड़े होते होते ही डर चले जाते हैं और एक नया डर सामने आ जाता है।
अकेलेपन का. But with time, we make this with that too.
हम याद कर रहे हैं.
पर बुरा सपना एक ऐसी चीज है जिसका डर हमारे घर से कभी नहीं जाता. भले उम्र में कितने भी बड़े हो जाएं, जानते हो क्यों?
आप यहाँ?
जानते हो क्यों?
नहीं.
क्योंकि ये डर किसी बाहर की चीज जैसे अंधेरे या भूत या दूसरे इंसान का नहीं होता, जिसके होने या ना होने का पता हमें उम्र से मिली समझ से आ जाए. ये डर होता है हमें खुद के दिमाग से. हम अंधेरों को, भूतों को, इंसानों को, सबको खत्म कर सकते हैं, पर जीते जी अपने खुद के दिमाग को खत्म नहीं कर सकते. इसलिए जब तक हम हैं तो ये दिमाग है, तो ये डर है. समझ रहे हो मैं क्या कह रहा हूँ?
जी.
मैंने सुना कल तुम राव जी का नाम अनाउंस करने वाले हो. That's good. Now you will again get to think about the most important thing in your life, your lunch.
आप मेरा मजाक उड़ा रहे हैं?
हाँ. Let's see. You single-handedly led the Congress to the biggest win in the history of this country in the 1984 elections. While in office, you generated 2 million new jobs. You removed the license raj, helped with the riots, the Khalistan movement, helped peace in the whole country. Your foreign policies have brought in several investors to pour in thousands of crore into the Indian market. And not to even talk about the poverty ratio which has gone down substantially. And guess what? There still are 10 crore more people since the time you took your office. There are just 6. You know why? Because of your family planning initiative. And there are several such initiatives which are still in the pipeline. Which I'm sure most of the leaders don't even have the intellect or the vision to understand. And so, we'll just dump them. And you are going to announce someone else as an HTM candidate from your party. So, am I the one making fun of you? Or it's you?
You forgot something.
Excuse me?
In that list, among all the things you said I did, there was Bofors and Sri Lankan case too. Which, by the way, you two think were wrong.
It doesn't matter what I think of you. It doesn't matter what anybody thinks of you. What matters is what you think of yourself. Do you think those decisions were wrong? Tell me, do you think those decisions were wrong?
No.
Say it out loud.
No.
Louder.
No.
Do you think you've done something wrong?
No.
Do you think you deserve to be punished?
No.
Do you think that they will run the country better than you did?
No.
Do you think it's a good decision to give them the rig then?
No, no, no.
Then why are you doing so? If you really think that you don't deserve to be the PM, then go ahead. Do what you want to. But if you are doing what you're doing because you think it will be too tough to do otherwise, then let me tell you, you have lost the fight to your mind, to your inner fear. And a loser surely doesn't deserve to be the Prime Minister of this country.
कभी नहीं बन पाता अगर शाहजहां ने भी कोर्ट्स मंगवाए होते और उसमें से भी लोएस्ट कोर्ट को चूज किया होता.
सर, आपका लकी पेन.
मिस्टेक. यू कॉल सेविंग पीपल्स लाइफ अ मिस्टेक. हेल्पिंग अ वीक नेबर अ मिस्टेक. ट्राइंग टू अपहोल्ड डेमोक्रेसी अ मिस्टेक. इफ दीज थिंग्स आर मिस्टेक्स देन यस I have committed not one but many mistakes. But guess what? I don't regret any of it.
Sir, the elections are due in a month and the Congress has yet not decided its candidate for the post of the PM. Although you are the party leader and the ex-PM, but there are stories that you might not be it. Would you mind telling us whether or not you are the candidate for the post of the PM?
Never, sir. You will never get that life back. You know why? Because that's too ordinary. And you are too special to have a life like that. You are not here because of some accident. You are here because you are destined to. And you deserve it.
Sir, are you not the candidate for the post of the PM?
Yes, I am.
Sir.
So with the Beaufort scandal and the decision of sending the IPKF to Sri Lanka not going down too well with the huge Tamilian population down south, don't you think it'll be difficult for you to win?
Before answering that question, I would like to share a story with you all. So listen up. एक कबूतरों का समुदाय था। अब हुआ यूं कि उनके राजा के घर एक मुर्गे ने जन्म ले लिया। अब सब हैरान कि भाई कबूतर के घर मुर्गा कैसे? पर उससे भी बड़ी चिंता इस बात की थी कि भाई कल को जब ये मुर्गा उनका राजा बनेगा तो नेतृत्व कैसे करेगा, जबकि वो खुद तोड़ नहीं सकता। तो महामंत्री ने कहा कि मुर्गा हुआ तो क्या हुआ, पंख तो है, हम इसे उड़ाएंगे। सब ने ठान ली कि मुर्गे को उड़ा कर रहेंगे, उसे उड़ना सिखाने लगे। मुर्गा कहता रहा कि उससे नहीं होगा, भगवान ने उसे उड़ने के लिए नहीं बनाया है। पर सारे कबूतर भी जिद्दी, बेमन से मुर्गा उनकी बात मानकर कोशिश करता रहा, बार बार गिरता, फिर उठता, फिर गिरता। और एक दिन कुछ ऐसा चमत्कार हुआ कि वो उड़ने लगा। हाँ, एक मुर्गा उड़ने लगा। सब खुश हो गए और सबसे ज्यादा खुश हुआ वो मुर्गा खुद। पहली बार उड़ने की खुशी में वो उड़ता चला गया और उड़ते उड़ते अपने इलाके से काफी दूर एक दूसरे इलाके में चला जाए। वहां से देखा कि ये इलाका तो चमत्कारी है। उस इलाके में सब कुछ सोने का था, पेड़, फूल, पत्ती, सब। उसकी आंखें चली आ गई। वो तुरंत वापस आया और सबको स्वर्ण इलाके के बारे में बताया। उसने कहा कि उन सबको ये इलाका छोड़कर स्वर्ण इलाके में जाकर रहना चाहिए। पर किसी ने उसकी बात पर भरोसा नहीं किया। सबको लगा कि वो झूठ बोल रहा है। सब उससे सबूत मांगने लगे। तो सबूत लाने अगले दिन वो फिर उड़ चला उसी इलाके की ओर। पर इस बार वो रास्ता भटक गया और एक बिजली के तार से उलझकर अपने पंख चला बैठा। अब वो उड़ नहीं सकता था। अपने समुदाय को उस स्वर्ण इलाके में ले जाने का उसका सपना चूर चूर होता नजर आया। पर वो इतनी जल्दी हार मानने वालों में से नहीं था। वो अगले ही दिन से अपने जले हुए पंखों के साथ ही उड़ने लगा। सारे कबूतर उससे बोले कि तू अब कैसे उड़ेगा, तेरे तो पंख ही जल गए हैं। जानते हैं उसने क्या जवाब दिया? जानते हैं? उसने कहा, याद है कुछ दिन पहले तक ये मैं कहा करता था कि मैं तो एक मुर्गा हूं, उड़ नहीं सकता, पर आप लोग मेरे पीछे पड़े थे। तब मैं ना ही उड़ना जानता था और ना ही उड़ना चाहता था, पर फिर भी मैं उड़ा, एक मुर्गा उड़ा। अब तो मैं उड़ सकता हूं और अब मैं उड़ना चाहता भी हूं और उड़ना जानता भी हूं। पंख चले हुए तो क्या हुआ, अगर एक मुर्गा उड़ सकता है तो वह चले हुए पंखों के साथ भी उड़ सकता है। Now coming back to your question, yeah, I know my feathers are burnt and it will be painful and very difficult for me to fly again, but it's not impossible. I have done before and I will do it again, and I will take my country to the golden place which only I have seen. India will go there and live there. India will live there because we deserve to be there. And I will be the one, yes, I will be the one leading India to that place. You know why? You know why? Because only I have seen that place. Only I have seen that place. Thank you.
अपनी धरती, अपना आकाश पैदा कर, अपनी हर सांस में एक नया विश्वास पैदा कर। मांगने से कुछ भी मिलता नहीं जहां में, अपने हाथों से अपना इतिहास पैदा कर, अपने हाथों से अपना इतिहास पैदा कर।
Check.